ஸ்டார்ட் பண்றது ஸ்டார்ட் சார் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்றப்ப நான் எதுவும் பண்ண தேவையில்ல அப்படியே டைரக்ட்
Gracias. Good afternoon, ma'am. Ma'am, is it audible?
No, sir. Whether I am
audible, ma'am?
No, I'm not hearing anything, sir.
Now, sir, you.
Ma'am, audible?
No.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. Whether okay, I am audible, sir?
Right.
Whether I am audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Oh.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay.
மேல தெரியுதா? இப்போ ஓகேவா இப்போ ஓகேவா பாரு இப்படி குனியணுமா ஓ இப்போ ஓகேவான்னு பாருமா பாயம் முடிச்சு உட்கார வைக்கிறீங்கம்மா இப்ப எதுவும் தெரியலல்ல அது செக் பண்ணிருக்காங்க நினைக்கிறேன் அப்படியா இப்ப தெரியல நானு தெரியுதா உங்களுக்கு பாருங்க
ஹலோ
ஹலோ
ஹலோ மேம்
ஹலோ மேம்
எஸ் மேம்
பி ஏபிள் டு ஹியர் மீ
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We
could hearing, hear hearing.
Hello, ma'am. Sorry. Welcome, ma'am.
Okay. Sorry, making.
Hello, welcome, ma'am.
வீடியோ ஓபன் பண்ணுங்க சீலா
Shall we start now?
Yes.
Is it audible?
Yes, it's audible.
Hello, everyone. A warm good afternoon to one and all. We feel delighted and thank you everyone for this wonderful gathering by spending your valuable time with us by visiting today's webinar. I would like to invite you all of this webinar on the topic of newborn care in India, presented by our eminent speaker, Dr. S. Rajeshwari, HOD of Obstetrics and Gynecological Nursing, Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai, organized by Nanda College of Nursing, Erode. On this fine afternoon, we feel proud to inform about Nanda College of Nursing is one of the leading institutions dedicated to leadership, social welfare, and excellence by quality education, which was established in the year of 1998. Under the dynamic leadership of our chairman, Thiruvi Shanmugan, and our secretaries, Thiru S. Nandakumar Pradeep, Secretary, Nanda Educational Trust, and Thiru S. Thirumurthy, Secretary, Nanda Educational Institution. Due to their aspiration to provide quality education and encouragement, the college has grown up in all academic fronts and accredited by NAC. So, delegates, be ready with your mesmerizing mood and update your knowledge to future step after your education. Next, we also pleased to welcome our respected principal, Professor R. Vasanthi, Nanda College of Nursing. She is a great driving force with inherent special capabilities, leading power, and reflecting like a guiding star for us. And today she is the reason for this webinar with our resource person. Now I invite our principal for giving welcome speech to our participants from various institutions. Please, ma'am.
Good afternoon, one and all. I welcome each and every one of you for the virtual webinar on newborn care in India. Dear delegates, I assure you that definitely you are going to have a wonderful seminar webinar and deep knowledge regarding the newborn care, and you can apply this knowledge in the clinical aspect as well as in the research areas. First of all, I would like to welcome our resource person, the most eminent personality, Dr. S. Rajeshwari, Reader, HOD, Department of Obstetric and Gynecological Nursing Department, Sri Ramachandra College of Nursing, Chennai, for this wonderful webinar. I welcome you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for accepting our invitation and being connected with us today. Thank you and welcome you once again, ma'am. And also I extend my warm welcome to all the delegates, principals, professors, HODs, lecturers, a registered nurse of various institutions for this virtual webinar. I express my sincere gratitude to our chairman, Thiruvi Shanmugan, and our secretaries, Thiru Nandakumar Pradeep and Thiru Thirumurthy, for providing this wonderful
platform for us to conduct this webinar. And also I extend my sincere gratitude to our administrative officer, Dr. K. Krishnamurthy, who is always with us in all our endeavors. And also I extend my sincere thanks to Dr. Apollo James, administrative officer of Nanda OIS Institution, for providing all the technical support throughout this program. And I express my thanks to Professor Renha, HOD, Department of Child Health Nursing, Nanda College of Nursing, for organizing this wonderful webinar. And also the faculties, Mrs. Sneha, lecturer, and Ms. Subha Jayanti, lecturer, and Ms. Jayanti, assistant lecturer, for continuous support which they have provided us for the wonderful organization of this webinar. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable address. We will go ahead to today's session, and definitely there will be an interaction session with you. Just reminder, please be sure to type your question into the question box in your control panel. It will be discussed with your resource person at the end of this event in the questionnaire session. Now we invite our Professor V. Renuga, Child Health Nursing, to give an introduction about our resource person.
I am Professor Renuga, Department of Child Health, Nanda College of Nursing from Bangalore, and I am here to introduce our resource person, Dr. S. Rajeshwari, MSc Nursing, PhD, working leader and HOD of Obstetrics and Gynecological Nursing, Faculty of Nursing, Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research. She completed her degree from Annamalai University and PhD degree from Sri Ramachandra University, Chennai. She completed her PhD from Annamalai University and PhD degree from Sri Ramachandra University in 1994 and 2002 respectively. She received her PhD in 2019 from Sri Ramachandra University. She has served in various positions, starting from clinical instruction to leader and faculty of obstetrics and gynecological nursing, with 23 experience of in the field of nursing. She has presented papers in various national and international forums. She has seeking publication to her credit. She is also a committee member in the Nursing Education Unit, Board of Studies of Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research, College Governing Council, Library Committee Member, and Secretary. She also serves as the editorial board member and the reviewer of nursing journals. She also has the examiner and question paper selected in the following universities: the Tamil of the Indian Medical University, Chennai, Rajiv Gandhi University, Karnataka, Annamalai University, Sikandaram, Pondicherry University, Puducherry, Sri Venkateshwara Institute of Medical Science, Tirupati, Meenakshi University, Chennai, NTR University, Andhra Pradesh, Sri Ramachandra University, Chennai, and the recipient of award for 20 years of service from the Chancellor of Sri Ramachandra University on 19-9-2018. With this introduction, I am handing over the session to our resource person, Dr. S. Rajeshwari, are very happy to have Nanda super platform. Now, thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Can I start, ma'am? It's audible.
Yes, yes, it's audible, ma'am.
It's clear.
Yes, clear, ma'am. Clear, ma'am.
Respected Thiru Nandakumar Pradeep, Secretary Sri Nanda Educational Trust, Erode, Professor Dr. Vasanthi, Principal Nanda College of Nursing, Professor Renuka, Department of Pediatric Nursing, Nanda College of Nursing, Mrs. Sneha, Lecturer, Nanda College of Nursing, Mrs. Jayanti, Nursing Student, Nanda College of Nursing, and all other participants, very good afternoon to one and all gathered here. First of all, I would like to thank my sincere thanks to the management as well as the principal for inviting me resource person to talk and to share about the topic. And also, I wanted to give special note of thanks to Prof. Renuka. I think for the past 2 weeks, we are just interacting and organizing this event. And also, she was given very much freedom to even choose the topic. Thank you, Professor Renuka. And I thought I can just talk something about COVID-19 because it's a hot issue. But again, like a lot of people talking about COVID, I thought better not. So let us explore and a few concept which is known and that thing to be reviewed and a few concepts we have to yet to understand, explore, and a few things are not known by us. So with that context, I thought this topic would be rather benefit for the participant. Hope I could see the participant around 85 to 90 here, maybe from in and around the College of Erode or Coimbatore. With the small note of thanks, I want to again register one more thing. The participation of Innoverse 2020 by the Nanda College of Nursing, really it was appreciable. And their effort taken, the attitude towards the concept presented was really made to fetch prizes. For this, once again, I appreciate the Nanda College of Trust as well as the principal for preparing the professional such a way so that they could present themselves in a professional manner. I think it will be ideal environment for them to grow, and I could envisage that they will be better professional. So all the credit go to the management as well as the principal faculty member who are involved in this team. With this small note, let me just start with my presentation. Yes, the topic of presentation today is care of newborn in India. And with the, as I already said, as the COVID is coming up, the situation is really killing, the education program is flipped up, rather getting into the student into the classroom, we just started dealing with the online. And I thought, so with this really causing the student to get a lot of tension, frustration, and uncertainty, and even irritability, and even some are going for depression. I think this sort of interaction really would help the student to just come to the professional forum and meet and join each other and get to know each other, share their knowledge, and obviously it's going to help for the professional practice. And with that, this session for the coming 45 to 1 minute, I used to talk certain concept, the newborn, the care of the newborn, immediate as well as essential care, and neonatal mortality in our country, and what's the target set by various organizations, what are the neonatal program, national program, which is helping for the newborn survival. So with this outline, I would like to get into the topic. And before getting to the who's newborn and what is the care supposed to begin, I want to just give a brief concept about a number of birth in various countries. Here, I could list out few countries and birth rate. It is the average birth rate for the past 5 years. So that means here the figures are given in 1,000. That means for the past 5 years, 12 crore birth we could able to get. And coming to, even though China is a populated country, they could have started controlling the birth. It was just 8 crores. And other USA, of course, is 2 crores of birth. They could be able to face for the past. That means an average in India, 1,000 population, even though the China is having highly populated, as they started having their own birth control measure, the birth rate started reducing. That's the reason even the number of birth rate has come down. Number of birth has come down to 8 crore. And even USA is the second most populated country coming up. It is having birth rate hardly 12.5 per 1,000 population. Other countries, even though like Nigeria, Mali, Uganda is having higher birth rate, but still as the base population is lesser, the population of the particular country is more. So now you can understand the magnitude of the population in our country. So almost every year, more than 2 crore of baby we do receive. So obviously our composition is prevalent in rural and urban component. So that makes us give more importance for the newborn care. It is a small background. Let us get into the topic. So this famous popular definition given by Dutta, you know who is the newborn. Newborn is obviously healthy newborn who is supposed to born a term in between 38 weeks to 41 completed weeks, should have an average birth weight for the country. Usually should be exceeding 2.5 kg. And suppose we baby supposed to be crying immediately following birth, establishes independent rhythmic respiration and quickly adapt to the changed environment. And for our country, even though we say it's a 2.5 is a birth weight, and it should be average between normal birth weight supposed to be average between 2.7 to 3.1 kg with the mean birth weight of 2.9, and the length supposed to be between 48 to 55 centimeter. And certain classification I wanted to review before getting into the topic. So I think these are the popular classification you are familiar. Classified based on the gestation age. Of course, we know preterm, term, and postterm based on the gestational age. At 37 cutoff weeks is considered. Before 37 weeks, of course, the preterm or premature baby. And the term, of course, 37 completed to 41 completed week of gestation. Postterm, of course, the baby born after 42 weeks. Based on this birth weight, we do classify low birth weight babies. But baby less than 2.5 kg, very low birth weight baby, more, less than 1,500, and extremely low birth weight baby is the less than 1,000 gram. Based on gestation, based on the gestation, baby again classified appropriate for gestation. That means weight is appropriate for the country. We do have a appropriate for gestation, AJA baby, small for gestation, large for gestation. Here, small for gestation, you are pretty well knows when the baby birth weight falls less than 10th percentile according to the gestational age. So for us, for our country, for the term baby born between 37 to 42 weeks, we expect to have at least more than 2.5 kg. So if less than 2.5 kg is supposed to be a less than 10th percentile. And large for gestation, it is considered when the birth weight is more than 90th percentile. It is nothing but when the birth weight is more than 4 kg, it is considered as a 90th percentile. I think often could have been heard 10th and 19th percentile, but you could be able to correlate the weight. So less than 2.5 kg in for term baby in India, it is considered as a less than 10th percentile. And coming to the care component, when we are conducting labor, the preparation start from the preparation of the labor room during delivery process, and certain care which are given during immediately after birth, and there are some of the ongoing essential postnatal care. So these are the three important care you have to concern when you are talking about newborn concept. And when you are giving care to the newborn, these are the certain principle always you have to know in mind. I think it's all already learned topic. It is a sort of review. So obviously, establishment of respiration, prevention of hypothermia, establishment of breastfeeding, prevention of infection, identification at risk during birth. So these are the component is very important concept you have to abide when you are giving care to the newborn. Okay, what is the preparation of the labor room? And preparation of the labor room delivery include a few things. Always we will be worried about mother component. As a newborn care corner, there are certain things, essential thing you have to get, keep it ready before conduction of the labor. And obviously, better to be under radiant warmer, baby to be kept, and you should have a ambu bag, mucus extractor, and clean cloth, a pre-warmed cloth to drape the baby and maintain temperature, oxygen source, suction source, nasal catheter, laryngoscope, pediatric set, as well as weighing scale. And when you are conducting the delivery, we expect delivery room supposed to be warm, clean, supposed to be sterile, at least more than 25 degrees centigrade. Less than 25 degrees, it may cause hypothermia to the newborn. And even after immediately the birth, we are expected, anticipated to have a warm cloth, as not only clothes, the pre-warmed towel, even caps and socks are necessary to maintain the newborn body temperature. As we're just getting ready for the labor, not only assembling the things is important, and also it's important that we have to pre-check the articles necessary. We have to assure that all the articles are working properly. And also few questions you have to ask obstetrician. What are the few important questions? Whether the baby, what is the baby's gestational age? Is it term, preterm, or postnatal? And what is the amniotic status? Is it clear or Meconium strain or blood strain? Any abnormality? And it is a singleton or multiple birth? Or whether the baby as well as mother having any additional risk factor? So these are the important questions you should be uptight. And based on that, based on the risk status, you have to make your team briefing to be done. So who can be taking which role to resuscitate? And equipment check is very important component, as I've been already discussed. And coming to, let us, these are the pre-preparation. So article check for the baby and the environment of the labor room, as well as few important background information being obtained from the healthcare provider. With that, we have to just continue to give immediate basic care. So immediate basic care, you know, the basic principle, TABC, T mean temperature, A, airway, B, breathing, C, circulation. Adult, we always talk about ABC, but here coming to the newborn concern, TABC is very important. So even though these things are given independently, like temperature maintenance, airway circulation, other thing, but all will go simultaneously throughout the newborn period, even after that. It is not independent. One completed and doing other meeting other thing. All the temperature maintenance, airway, breathing, circulation, all to be taken care of simultaneously, and also is to be persistently continued throughout the newborn period. So what is the immediate newborn care? Just sequentially I will just give it. So as soon as baby is born, generally you have to call out the time of birth. So it will be alert the obstetrician and newborn just receive the baby. And it should be, I think generally it to be done by the nurses, because they are the person going to receive the baby and going to do immediate newborn care. Or they may hand over the baby to the professional pediatrician who are going to attend the baby. And generally, after immediately birth, generally we'll place the baby on the mother's abdomen and dry the baby with warm, clean sheet. Clear the mouth and nose. Always you follow the alphabet N followed by N. So clearing or suctioning should start from the mouth and nose, because we have to clear as the baby is crying. If any secretion is there inside the mouth, it may get aspirated. And assess the baby breathing as we are dry, and cord clamping after a minute. So this is something called delayed clamping. Even active management at third stage always insists the cord to be clamped after 1 minute, it is having beneficial, that what you are going to see little later. And to tie the identity label of the newborn before detaching the baby from the mother. And this and by the time it became a minute, so you have to do the upbarring. And there are certain care to be followed at the radiant warmer. So better the newborn labor room should be having the radiant warmer to care the baby. So the warmer should be tilted 15 degree head low, so that the head will be in the lower angle compared to the leg component, so that will help to drain the secretion by the gravity from the tracheobronchial tree. And now we have to size and clamp the cord, and generally 4 finger breath practically, or 2 inches ear to leave it, and clamp the cord. In case it is going to be preterm baby, about double the length ear to leave, because the umbilical cord is act as a resource for just starting IVF. So umbilical vein catheter is a common procedure being performed for the preterm as well as high risk baby. Such as indication, you have to increase the cord length as a double the time, and give vitamin K 1 milligram. In case preterm, it's supposed to be 0.5 milligram. That's very familiar to know. And quickly we do examine the malformation and birth injuries. And we do record the weight, and always cover the baby, change the cloth now and then. And so that 2 to 3 pre-warmed cloth must be kept ready, so that the baby temperature maintenance is very important. So temperature maintenance like hypothermia, hypoxia, hypoglycemia is a Vicasian cycle, won't happen, that may cause other. So hypothermia may cause again hypoglycemia and hypoxia. So like the 3 are interrelated connectively. So for the newborn component, the covering is very important, especially head covering. And within 30 minutes as per the baby friendly hospital initiative policy, you have to start initiating breastfeeding and rooming in, always putting the mother and baby together. So these are the general care we do give during immediate newborn period. So as I said, all the principle what you learned, it is not done only at a particular moment time, it should be ongoing. So how to maintain the temperature? So immediately dry and keeping the baby under radiant warmer, skin to skin contact whenever possible. So soon after delivery, we do putting the baby over the mother's abdomen to maintain skin to skin contact. After stabilization again, after radiant warmer care, when the baby is getting stabilized again, we are shifting the baby back to the mother's chest for feeding. And always keeping the newborn head covered and rooming. So these are the certain protocol to be followed. Other than that, WHO has given something, they insisting about something called warm chain. So there are 10 aspects to be taken care throughout the newborn, even later period of the life. So warm delivery room, as we discussed already, labor room supposed to be having temperature of more than 25 degrees centigrade. Immediate drying, the pre-warmed towel especially important. Skin to skin contact before even cutting the umbilical cord. Breastfeeding as early the baby is established, satisfactory respiration and crying. And bathing can be postponed maybe after 24 hours to prevent neonatal hypothermia. And appropriate clothing and bedding is important to maintain the thermoregulation. Baby and keeping baby and mother together, something called rooming in, that to be taken care. Not only that, the few concepts we do just give away, like during transportation, during resuscitation, in case of sick baby. And so even that particular time, you have to just take warm environment. And not only that, finally, the training and awareness is very important among health professional. And so these are the 10 principal concepts you have to have it in your mind when you're maintaining warm chain, because the thermoregulation is very important for the newborn. Establishment of open airway. So generally it is initiated as early as the head is come out, before the entire body is delivered. We just started doing the suction, maybe using the bulb sucker. But again, this policy may differ from hospital to hospital. So as the head is come out, before the baby shoulder and body to deliver, we do just using bulb sucker, we do just suck out the secretion. Always we have to mind the sucking part, mouth followed by the nose. Always remember the alphabet, M followed by N. And suction, and followed that, we during radiant warm care, keep the head down so that the draining by gravity do occur, and the secretion may not get clogged into the respiratory system. And position either on the back or tilting or sideways is helping the baby to drain every secretion. And third component, something called pod clamping. So we are talking about delayed clamping. Delay, it is not delayed for many hours or minutes. It is just keeping, waiting for after baby delivery, just waiting for a complete 60 second or 1 minute. It's called delayed cord clamping. As picture here shows, if you are cutting the cord immediately, the baby could receive only hardly 10 to 50 ml of blood. If you wait for 60 seconds or a minute, baby do receive 45 ml of blood. You know, the blood volume for the baby is very less, maybe 80 ml per kg per body weight. So that means 2.5 kg hardly will have 200 ml of blood. So if you are just waiting for 1 minute, is going to help us to get extra 45 ml. That is going to be a big volume for the baby. So it is even recommended by the WHO. So delay cord clamping, always you have to have it in our mind. And there are very rare case we don't wait for, like babies having severe asphyxia, not crying. Only that case we just go for early clamping. Otherwise, you have to wait for at least a minute. And Abgar, I think this popular score you are very much familiar, 5 component maximum 10, and we know it, why for it is done. So obviously to assess the brain function, not only that, cardiovascular, respiratory status, to know that the Abgar score is a simple score, by that we can assess. Not only that, whether the baby's need of resuscitation, by noting the Abgar only we are going to plan. And as we already discussed, is a total of 10 score. And if 70-10 score means no respiratory depression, mild depression when the baby is having score between 4 to 6, severe depression when the baby is having 0 to 3. So what by that, what you're going to interpret and to do the significant. If normal, no depression, there is a minimal, it's we can consider as a healthy newborn. If baby is moderately depressed, need resuscitation, maybe ranging from PPV to the PPV and administration of oxygen suction. And in case of severe depressed baby, intensive resuscitation, maybe cardiac compression, other drugs are needed. So this is the Abgar score will signify us what is the amount of care we need to be given for the newborn. And identification, generally the tag must be kept ready. Even possibly you can have a 2 tag can be tied over the wrist and ankle. So if one misses, other can take in part. Vitamin K administration, you know, a baby newborn liver cannot synthesize vitamin K. We should be supplementing externally for the first week of life. And the term baby, of course, 1 milligram, don't say in ml, so 1 milligram per kg. Maybe 1 milligram available in 1 ml, but always mention in the gram rather than in ml. And preterm infant, of course, receives half of its amount, of course, in intramuscular route. Initiate on the breastfeeding as per the UNICEF protocol, baby friendly initiative, within half an hour is missed. As soon as the airway is cleared, breathing is stabilized, we can just initiate. So that is in turn going to improve the temperature, as well as is baby is going to find the mother, the temperature and feet together at a time if you are going to initiate the breastfeeding early. Okay, here I wanted to spend some time, something about newborn resuscitation from it. So out of 100 baby born in general, 80 to 85 baby need minimal care, that's provision of warm position, airway clearance by minimal suction, sometimes hardly oxygen supplementation, little stimulation, dryness is important, little stimulation too in order to maintain the breathing pattern. But 10 to 15% of the baby hardly need some extra support, like supplementary oxygen, like positive pressure ventilation, nothing but ampubec, and even sometime need intubation. There are very rare case, 1 to 5% of the baby only need cardiac compression and medication in order to make the baby survive. So this is a pyramid, will tell us what is the care and what is the proportion of the baby supposed to be receiving. So 80 to 85% of the baby just born normally, very minimal care is can be given. That can be given by the NMR trained healthcare providers like nurses. And maybe giving oxygen, of course, training is very important. NRP program is supposed to be undergoing to give a newborn resuscitation as ideal to undergo. And even chest compression, obviously need a team approach to tackle the baby. Okay, so here American Heart Association's given a brief about newborn resuscitation. I think could have been already undergone. Just again, I'll make it as a quick recall, because the immediate period is very important. We can say it's an immediate 1 hour or 60 minutes is called golden period. So by giving the proper care, proper attention, we are going to save the baby. So with that background, I thought I can just discuss, review quickly about newborn resuscitation. So any baby mother is going to get delivered, you have to look few things, whether the baby mother is normal mother, high-risk mother, and the according to the gestational age, the baby intrapartum condition, you have to get ready the team and equipment set must be ready. So as soon as the baby is born, whether you have to look for term baby, whether having good tone, like good activity, and baby could able to breathe or cry. And if in case the baby could able to breathe or cry, so we can just go for routine care. That's nothing but warm and maintain a normal body temperature by just covering and wiping out the secretion, positioning the airway, clearing secretion, and keeping the baby dry. And if does not occur, like baby tone is not good, baby is not crying, so you have to just continue to give warm and maintain the normal temperature. So the same amount you have to maintain airway. So how to maintain airway, I'll just come begin, we'll discuss in a subsequent slide. And clear secretion and dry and stimulate the baby. And still the baby is gasping, having heart rate below 100 beats per minute, you have to just go for positive pressure ventilation. It is nothing but starting ampubac ventilation. And irrespective of that, again, the heart rate is 100, less than 100, we have to think of repositioning or ventilating using laryngoscope or laryngeal mask or endotracheal tube to be out insert. And again, the heart rate is going down below 60, you have to think of ideal time to think of cardiac compression and giving drugs like epinephrine, and also managing other condition like hypovolemia. So these are, so kindly remember the basic care involved, just providing warm, maintaining, keeping the baby dry, maintaining the airway, and observation of the baby. And the heart rate below 100, just start with ampubac. So the ampubac should be given all assessments. So by 1 minute, you should be able to assess, able to establish the normal tone and crying, normal heart rate and respiratory rate. And if goes false, you have to start PP. This is all to be done, completed within 1 minute or 60 seconds of the life. And so other step starting, once PPV is not effective, heart rate still goes, and you have to just do ET. And so every other step, you have to just wait for 30 seconds. And just go proceed. We cannot going on trying ENT. Going on give oxygen to the baby. For 30 seconds, baby doesn't come out with a good improvement, we have to go for cardiac compression and PPV. So this is the sequence you have to follow. So we must be. So it's 1 minute is nothing. So with no matter of minute, we could be able to understand, assess, and initiate the care appropriately. Okay, so the basic care, I said warmth, maintaining normal temperature, positioning airway. If with that position, baby doesn't come out with a good heart rate, we have to just maintaining the position, something called sniffing position. It is like keeping a small rolled towel under the newborn shoulder, help to maintain the pharynx, trachea, respiratory tract in same in the straight alignment. Rather, when the baby is flexed or extended, that may just prevent straight alignment. So aeration may not be proper. So you have to, when you're talking about position for resuscitation, always you mind the sniffing position. Just keep a small rolled towel placed under the shoulder. And so this all we have to just finish by 1 minute. So with that position also, when the baby doesn't come out maintaining the normal respiratory rate of heart rate of 100 per minute, you have to just start with positive pressure ventilation. Don't just confuse with the bigger word of PPV. Just using bag and mask, ampubac for the ventilation. So how many ventilation you have to give if you are going to use the positive pressure? So if you're using positive pressure, 40 to 60 breaths should be given. How to give breath? The bag must be compressed so that you have to say as a breath, and to relax, you have to say 2-3. So when you're giving positive pressure ventilation, the number is supposed to be 40 to 60, and you have to have your rhythm of as a positive pressure ventilator who are giving ventilation, always they have to say breathe 2-3, breathe 2-3. So this is the rhythm they have to follow, they are giving ventilation, but the speed you have to maintain 40 to 60 breathe per minute. So this is about positive. So again, I recall when the heart rate falls less than 100, irrespective of initial measures, you have to just after a minute, you have to start positive pressure ventilation. Again, if you are giving positive pressure ventilation, you should be get connected with the oxygen source, because positive pressure ventilation would only yield only 40% of the oxygen. And so if you are connecting the oxygen resource, that will help us to ensure 100% of the 100% of the oxygenation to the baby. So that always you have to maintain. And again, irrespective of positive pressure ventilation, the baby doesn't breathe, you have to do certain recheck. That's called Mr. Sopa. What is Mr. Sopa? M for adjust a mask to reassure. So when you are keeping the upper bag must be appropriate, that must be properly sealing the mouth, nose, and certain part of the cheek, side of the cheek. So that's a proper position, masking. And the reposition, sometimes the baby, due to this masking application, baby position might have been changed. You have to reposition, keeping head in the sniffing. And suction, so secretion may disappear at any time. So you have to redo the suction and open the mouth widely. And increase the pressure of the ampu bag, and you have to do the positive pressure. Irrespective of that, baby doesn't need, we have to think of putting ET tube or laryngeal mask to initiate aeration to give oxygen to the baby. Then when is the time to think of chest compression? As I said already, after even 1.5 to 2 minutes, when the baby doesn't maintain the positive heart rate 100 or started going down, especially when it is going down to 60. Adult will just look for the asystole, but here for the newborn, when heart rate goes less than 60, you have to think of cardiac compression or chest compression. And so during even chest compression, you have to assure that positive pressure ventilation to be continued. So what are the number of compression? I think you are very clear with the newborn compression. And compression can be given by using two thumbs. And the pressure, as is directed in the picture, on the lower part, lower one third of the CP sternum, you have to give pressure. So this is a down below what the picture shows is the abnormal pressure that may not give effective cardiac compression. And what is the amount of pressure you have to give? So sternum supposed to be compressing for 1/3 of the chest, and do not lift the finger in between contraction. What is the number of compression and ventilation? So compression ventilation ratio, of course, 3:1. So for every 1 minute, we are expected to give 90 compression and 30 ventilation. 3:1 ratio you have to maintain. So that means this picture is going to clearly give us how we supposed to carry on cardiac compression. So you have to give compression 1 and 2 and 3 and breathe. So breathe 2, 3. So 3 compression, 1 ventilation by PPV bag, by ampu bag should be completed by 2 seconds. So that means end of 1 minute, we could be able to achieve 90 compression and 30 ventilation. So not like adult. Adult will go for 15:2, but here it is ratios higher. Every 3 compression, 1 breathe is important. So how you have to give compression 1 and 2 and 3 followed by breathe 2, 3. So again, 1 and 2 and 3. So this rhythm we have to follow throughout the initial period of resuscitation. So with that, the cardiac heart rate does not pick up. Baby is still flaccid, not active. You have to start thinking of giving epinephrine. So dosage, of course, 1 in 10,000. We do give either ET or umbilical vein catheter, and 0.1 to 0.3 ml per kg is administered. It can be repeated. So, and how long you are going to give medication, all these measures. So generally we have to try. So to start till PPV, it will take 1 minute. Other chest compression ended tracheal 2 to 3 minutes. And so after 5 minutes for continuous, irrespective of continuously performing all the measures, ABC, if asystole persists for more than 10 minutes, so we have to just consider of discontinue the newborn resuscitation. And also the, at the same time, you have to think of any associated complications like pneumothorax, diaphragmatic hernia, and congenital heart disease are there. So such you have to consider. Or in case of hypovolemia or acidosis, even that correction also to be considered. So I think the first 5 minutes is a very golden period of time. In that you have to just take all important precaution. You have to decide that is going to determine the baby's life. So again, recall. So initial minute, we just giving basic care, that is the warmth, maintaining temperature, position, airway, clearing secretion. And does not, if baby is doing well, if the heart rate goes less than 100, you just go for positive pressure. And if the heart rate goes less than 60, you should go for cardiac compression with ventilation. Again, it persisted for other 30 seconds to 1 minute, you should go for medication. So this is a simple neonatal resuscitation protocol you have to consider when you are giving immediate newborn care. Okay, so by that, hopefully the baby succeeded and reached the normal, right, maintaining normal cardiorespiratory status. Now let us think about essential newborn care that could be offered by, should be given by the healthcare professional. So it should be started as soon as the baby is stabilized till throughout the newborn period. And of course, the major goals of the newborn care, establish, maintain homeostasis, stability of the normal physiological status of the newborn. Okay, what are the care routinely it is given? So almost warmth is not one-time process, is throughout the newborn, even later period of infant, breastfeeding, skin care, bath, care of umbilicus, care of eyes, clothing, general care, certain observation, something about anthropometry measurement, follow-up and advices, warning signs you are going to look at. Warmth has been discussed already deeply, WHO, warm chain, so all to be considered, content to be taken care throughout the newborn period. So keep the baby always dry, and even the nappy should be changed frequently as soon as it's getting wet. And possible use of 2-layer cloth that is going to trap the air, prevent being baby getting chilled. And covering the head and extremity is very important, because for the newborn, 25% of the head surface area, body surface area by the head. So just covering head, we are going to protect 25% of the body surface area. So that is very important, because usually the head may not be taken care by the mother. That information to be given. And the extremity equally important. And the rooming in practices to be continued throughout the infant period. Breastfeeding. So as early, we are very familiar, within half an hour baby should be started, and breastfeeding should be ongoing. So generally we know the principle of demand feeding is very important. Not only demand feeding, the night feeding is important. Why night? Because during night, the hormone prolactin is secreted high, that will help to maintain the lactation. So the mother may feed well without any hormone problem. So, and position, other things, is a detailed concept, I think we're familiar. So demand feeding and night feed is very important. So that concept you have to have it in your mind. Skin care and baby bath, as we already learned, soon after the baby, the newborn baby bath is not advisable. As the baby is getting stabilized, it can be done after 24 hours. So that is advocated. And according to the climate, either daily bath, baby sponging can be decided by the environment where the mother is living. Cord care, there is no special cord care secured. As you know, we are going for dry cord care, but there are such infection notice. We can just go using antiseptic solutions and preparation. And how to identify the cord being infected? Maybe we can find any oozing or discharge from the umbilicus. Otherwise, as you are just touching the stem or base of the umbilicus, when the baby is crying, that is early signs of cord infection. So that to be taken care. Care of eyes, again, it's not routine. Care is advocated in case baby having any secretion that can be cleansed, and maybe with prescription antibiotic creams and drops can be applied. So near clearing eyes if needed, you have to use two separate soaps, clean from inner to outer canthus is very important, and you should not use the same thing, same soap for both eye. Clothing, obviously it should be seasonal, and maybe better to be dressed loose, not too tight, and clothing must be very soft, better to be cotton cloth for Indian contest, and maybe the frock, like tying either front or back, may be beneficial. Maybe cloth is having large buttons, that takes plastic nylon should be avoided, and maybe the cloth or the napkin also to be avoided. And the general care include grooming, in always keeping the mother and baby together in a bed rather in the cradle or in some other separate place. Gentle handling of the patient, because skin and other systems are so fragile, it should be gentle approach. All better to be following aseptic technique, at least clean technique when feeding, when changing the napkin, like hand washing is very basic to prevent infection. Sensory stimulation, like talking with the baby, just giving the colorful toys during late neonatal period may be beneficial for the newborn to develop better in terms of sensory stimulation. And obviously tender loving care, that is can be promote mother baby bonding. Observation, continuous observation to be made in the hospital at least twice by terms of checking vitals and weight every day, so that we can identify the weight changes. Other anthropometric measure, I think we're so familiar. These are the four anthropometric measure we do consider: weight, length, head and chest circumference. Weight, we do just initial 7 to 10 days baby do lose weight. After that, there is a gain in 30 gram weight per day. And during second month, baby do gain 20 gram. And after the second month, 10 gram weight kg we can appreciate throughout the infant period. And coming to the weight loss, I think important task to be performed by the nursing student. So generally we anticipate 10% of the weight loss for the term baby. In case of preterm baby born before 37 weeks, we can anticipate 10-15%. So how to identify, how to calculate 10%? Very simple. So make, in case baby birth weight you consider 2.5 kg, so you can just make it as a 2500. You just remove the last digit, one digit there in ones. So remaining 250. So for 2.5 kg, 10% is just 250 milligrams. So this is the way. So suppose the baby is 3.2 kg, the expected weight loss would be 320 gram. So this is a simple way we can identify what is that 10% of the weight loss. So sir, nursing student, nursing professional, you should be able to identify how much the baby can lose. Again, you have to calculate. We said 10% baby can lose its body weight. So that means a term baby of 2.5 kg can lose 250 gram during first week of life. But it will not happen one particular day. It is ongoing within 1 week to 10 days is going to happen. So as a professional, again, we could able to calculate how much a baby lost weight. So how we are to calculate the weight loss? Weight loss by birth weight into 100. So suppose the baby birth weight we consider 2.5 kg. The next day when you're weighing the baby, it was 2.41. That means 2 kg, 410 grams. So that means 90 gram we could able to understand the weight loss had occurred. So how to calculate weight loss percentage? 90 gram by birth weight of 2500 into 100. So that comes about 3.6%. So when the baby is lost 90 gram, that for 2.5 kg, this is 3.6. So this formula is applicable. Always numerator, you just have the amount of weight loss, and the denominator, you just have the birth weight, always is a constant. And into 100 is also constant. So by that, I think you could be able to calculate the birth weight. So if birth weight lost more than 10%, that indicate either the baby is having repeated hypothermia, like baby is losing its temperature, or the baby feed is not adequate. And generally, when the baby losing weight more than 10%, need of intensive monitoring. So baby may be even shifted to the NICU for the monitoring sake. So again, it is our important consideration to be given to the mother, information to be given. Keep the baby always keep warm, like changing the nappy, covering the baby, keeping the baby away from the air vent, and maybe rooming in skin to skin contact, all is going to help, as well as the feed. So demand feed at least whenever 2 to 3, like 10 to 12 feeds per day, it is help to maintain the baby weight. So I think this two slides, which is help you to identify how to calculate the weight loss in terms of percentage and how to calculate the percentage of the weight loss. And coming to the length, so always 46 to 56 is the normal length of the newborn. If it is lesser than that, again we consider as a stunted growth. And head circumference, you know very well, it is higher than the chest, the 33 to 35 centimeter, and higher, 2 centimeter higher than the chest. It should be, as you are measuring, placing the tap, it should be placed over the occiput, over the eyebrow, you have to measure. And chest circumference, so 31 to 33 centimeter. And as you are measuring the tape should be encircling the scapula as follow, over the nipple line. So this is about the anthropometric measurement. And coming to the immunization, you know, well, and during immediate newborn period, we do just give certain vaccination. Of course, BCG, intradermal, generally the first day of life, immunization given. And zero dose of OPV and hepatitis B vaccination, all three is a birth vaccine, is advocatable. And follow-up care, generally, the WHO do recommend the follow-up care every once in 3 months, after that, subsequently 3 month interval. But practically, as a mother is coming for the vaccination, we just do the checkup. And so no extra checkup is advocated in our country. Then certain harmful practices, you're supposed to be knowing that. I think you are so familiar. Use of unclean substances for the body care, immediate bathing, use of pre-lacteal feed instead of breastfeeding, application of something to the eyes, installation of eye drops to the ear and nostril without prescription, hygienic use of herbal water may be beneficial, but it should be hygienic. Use of pacifier when the baby is crying, artificial feed before without trying the breastfeeding properly, and something other drinks for the newborn, and using expensive formula feed. See, that these are the some harmful practice you should not be following. And usually by 48 hours generally baby do get discharged, go for home care. So as the baby is getting discharged, you have to always talk about something called warning signs. What are the warning signs the mother supposed to be noting it? When the baby is not urinating for 24 hours, no bowel movement for 48 hours, when appearance of fever, cyanosis, convulsion, breathing difficulty, or any symptom of RDS, like some retraction, some sounds during the respiration, some discharge from the umbilicus, maybe malodorous or bleeding from the cord, and jaundice is getting worsened and spreading throughout the body. When the baby is so irritable and crying repeatedly, and other signs of sickness like a cough, diarrhea, pale skin are to be noted. Or sometimes when the baby is having poor appetite, refuse to suckle, this is also one of the important warning signs mother supposed to be noting it. And any other vomiting present, and vomiting of any color, even vomiting as such, and abdominal distances. So these are the certain warning signs mother supposed to be monitoring, noting, and she should be seeking the healthcare advices properly. So these are the certain important tips you should be giving to the mother as the mother is getting discharged. So this so far I do dealt about what is the immediate and essential care. Now let me talk about neonatal care in India and the community perspective. So again, to just recall the magnitude of the issue, I said that there is about more than 2 crores of the babies born in India, and not only birth, proportional death rate also higher. So globally, it is estimated that 2.5 million, that means 25 lakh baby are dying during the first month of life, during newborn period, and 7 7,000 newborn are dying globally. It is not Indian statistics, it's a global statistics by the 2018. So that means every 1 minute globally we do lose 5 babies. So you understand the magnitude, how much baby we are losing. And so even though neonatal, we do lose 2.5 million baby during first month of period. And the first week of life is big, first day and first week of life is very crucial. During first day, we do lose 1 million, that is 10 lakh. And again, say first week of life, again, we lose 1 million babies. And but a lot of measure being taken globally to reduce neonatal mortality. In 1990, it was 37. Of course, now it has come down to 18. I'm just talking about neonatal mortality, not the infant mortality. And so due to all the governmental effort, the newborn death rate has come down. It was 5.1 million in 1990, and it has come down to 2.5 million in to the half of come down in the year of 2018. And you know what, neonatal death of the newborn during first month of life or first 28 years of the life. How it is calculated? A death of the newborn during 28 days divided by the number of live birth into 100. So this formula to calculate neonatal death. And again, globally, neonatal death during first 4 weeks of life is nearly 15 times greater than the baby who was born before or during first year of life. That means the first month is obviously crucial there. The 15 times of higher death rate occur compared to any time of life. Either before birth as a fetus, even the death rate is stillborn rate is comparatively less, and even during the left out other 1 to 12 month of life. So the newborn period is crucial. It's causing 15 times higher of the death rate. And yet another important statistic we have to know, we are talking about there is 7.5 million death do occur. Out of that, 99% of the newborn death occur only in low and middle income countries. That means low income, so Africa and South Asia is coming to this category. Being a South Asian country, India, so we also being a part of that particular country. And so we have to, so 99% of the death occur only in low and middle income, not in higher income country. So again, you understand the magnitude of the death and problem of the our country, or low and middle income country. Coming to the Indian scenario, so every year we do lose 0.75 million. That means 7.5 lakhs baby we lose. And of course, the NMR rate has gone down drastically. And again, in India also, 75% of the death do occur during first week of life. And the cause of the death is given by WHO. So majority of the cause, of course, prematurity, 33%. And other, the cause, of course, the asphyxia. Here comes our professional role. So the golden 1 hour is very important to prevent birth asphyxia. Especially golden 1 minute and the first 1 hour is very important. Other cause, of course, sepsis, pneumonia, diarrhea, malformation. Other cause, of course, make the contribution of the neonatal death in India. And coming to the distribution of the death, during first week, out of all neonatal death, we do lose 73% during first week. Second week, the NMR rate is lesser, hardly 13.5, and again, third to fourth week, again, equal. And so, the first week of life of newborn is very crucial. And again, first week, the day of birth or 0 days very important. So out of all death, 40% of the 37% of the death do occur during the day of birth. So the day of birth is very important, and care is very important to prevent NMR in any country, in India too. And this SRS sample registration survey in 2012 tells us about what is the NMR rate in India. It is, of course, Kerala is less than 10. Tamil Nadu follows, is between 11 to 15. And less than 25 neonatal mortality is, of course, few six state only. Other majority of the state follow a higher rate of newborn mortality is more than 25. per 1000 population. So that means we got a long way to move and achieve the goal. As per Millennium Development Goal, it to set some target. So as per MDG, by 2015, the NMR rate supposed to be 38, but we could maintain only 64 only. And the IMR rate, they expected less than 30, but we could achieve. I'm telling about the whole India is 50. And the NMR rate supposed to be less than 20, but we our status is the 2010 statistics. We got long way to achieve the national target. Then I think the recent target is a sustained developmental goal. So by that, you do set some target for MMR, IMR. So as per SDG, the target set for the neonatal mortalities, it should come 12 per lakh, preferably by less than 10. Single digit newborn mortality rate you want to achieve, that's a target set and countries are working towards. And also they understood the non-communicable disease also the one of the reason for the newborn death. So other than communicable, other preventable measures, we do focus on preventing non-communicable disease among the mother and children so that we can improve the better neonatal health. Okay, other target, other action has come out. So something called the India Newborn Action Plan, INAP. Again, it has set some target to reach. This is purely about newborn component. So as per in India Newborn Action Plan, INAP target, so it want NMR to be reached less than 10 by the year of 2030. So 2025, at least 15 and 2030. Even it has given some target for all the component. Some important specific and technical component also to be given, like safe delivery. So old concept you are looking 95% initiation of breastfeeding within 1 hour, 90% looking forward. The woman with preterm labor receiving the at least one dose of antenatal steroids, because that's very important for lung maturity, prevent asphyxia. 95% we are looking by 2030. Baby born in health facility, so that resuscitation measure baby taken and the baby receiving care by home-based nursing care by ASHA, newborn with the sepsis community receiving antibiotic by NM and sick nursing care till 1 year and birth weight and premature reduction KMC. So it's all for 2025 and 2030 we are give a set target, and obviously the country is looking following this target, chasing and trying to meet the targets. And in order to meet all such target, they understood something called INAP is devised something called continuum of care. So continuum care is a care given from birth to, through the reproductive age, so that the mother, the baby, the adolescent, the mother will be healthy so that they could able to give a healthy baby. So what is the continuum of the care? It starts from the, there are very, very many components. The first thing about preconception and antenatal care. And what, so the, in that preconception antenatal care, the certain component can be given at the family and community level by the ANM or ASHA. The, some can be given at the sub-center level, some facility can be given at the like community health center and district hospital. So what are the pre-conceptional component? Reproductive health and family planning. So some bracket, it is something given E, something given S, something given A. E mean essential, S mean situational, A mean advanced component. So majority of the component, it is considered as an essential component. So under that, adolescent reproductive health, delaying age, marriage, and the first pregnancy, birth spacing is given. It can be information can be imparted at the community level. And nutritional relevant information like balanced diet and periconceptional conceptional folic acid supplementation, maternal calcium supplementation, multiple micronutrients like iron, folic acid, iodine, and nutritional counseling for adolescent and pregnant women, counseling and birth preparedness and prevention against malaria, only the endemic area is a situational component. At the subcenter level, antenatal screening for anemia and hypertensive disorder, because it's taking major toll causing preterm birth, screening for malaria, prevention management of mild and moderate and substandard level, maternal immunization, adolescent friendly services, and interval IUCD insertion at the substandard level. At the health facility level, a screening for severe anemia and hypertensive disorder, antenatal screening for hypothyroidism, hepatitis, malaria, adolescent friendly clinics, postpartum family planning, like postpartum IUCD insertion, prevention of Rh disease using and immunoglobulin. This is the care is insisted in various level. What is the care insisted during delivery? Maybe it is a repetition what we follow in the healthcare and the hospital level, and but still we should understand what all can be done in various level facility. At the family and community, all delivery should be attended by the skilled birth attendant. Skilled birth attendant, no more dolls, at least they should undergo training under they may be at least ANM. And the clean birth practices. Clean birth practices, 5-6, you know, clean hand, clean delivery surface, clean perineum, clean cutting of the cord, clean cord, and clean postnatal period. And outreach care for immediate during labor, identification of complication, pre-referral dose of ANM, like if needed in case of preterm labor, start, mother can be given a dose of corticosteroids like betamethasone 12 milligram with a 24 interval before mother referred to the higher level facility. And in case of PROM, even antibiotic is permitted by the ANM. And at the health facility higher level, emergency obstetrical care, like they include as per RCH2, basic and comprehensive maternity care, management of preterm labor using all such medication have been discussed. And care of immediate newborn care, I think as we learned, delayed cord care, again, don't confuse, this is a cord care. Cord is clamped after 60 seconds or 1 minute. Intervention to prevent hypothermia, major, sounds simple, but very important. Immediate drying, head covering, skin to skin care, delaying bath, and the early initiation of breastfeeding as well as exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months. Hygiene to prevent infection. At the community level, we did give vitamin K and newborn resuscitation measure. And if baby considered high risk, baby to report as at the health facility level, higher level, we do undergo baby to receive advanced neonatal resuscitation. And then in case of healthy newborn as ongoing essential care, home visit till 6 weeks by the trained ASHA or ANM. So counseling of the mother, prevention of hypothermia, cord care, early identification of the danger signs have been discussed early, prompt and appropriate refer, exclusive breastfeeding and clean postnatal practices. And the outreach services, they just give vaccination. And health facility level, all the intervention, which is just accompanied, is just discussed in other two level. And the care of small and sick newborn, thermal care and feeding support given in case of babies born as a preterm or born too soon. At the substandard level, integrated management using IMNC and oral antibiotic, and also the ANMs are permitted to use injectable antibiotic for the infection before even referral. And health facility level KMC, full supportive care at the block and district level, or that's something called block level you do got, newborn stabilizing unit, and the district level sick neonatal care units are just established, advocated, and there the baby do get care for the preterm. And intensive care at the regional level, maybe there such facilitation care like assisted ventilation, surfactant use surgery would be undertaken. And beyond care beyond the survival. So now the current motto, it is not making the babies to survive, and care beyond survival is very important. Okay, so the screening of the birth defect very important, and failure when baby living, and we want to have baby to thrive properly. So growth and development supposed to be proper. If it's not thriving, that is dangerous. Okay, so baby screening to be done at the family level, birth defect and failure to thrive under developmental defect. And the follow-up visit for essential discharged baby till 1 year, and even low birth babies, small for birth baby till 2 years. And at the facility level, newborn screening, management of birth defect, like treatment, diagnosis, surgery, and high-risk newborn baby is continued to monitor for development delay and appropriate management. Okay, these are the certain continuum care from the pre-conception and during labor, during immediate newborn care, as a continuing care for the sick baby is taken care and beyond. So making the baby survive is important. Making the baby thrive is the motto nowadays. So baby should be growing healthy and having normal growth and development. And so here I have listed out humpty number of program that is focusing on the newborn health of the country. It is a purely of Indian program, national program. So it is for newborn sake, there are a lot of programs there. It started from 1985. UIP is nothing but Universal Immunization Program. And CSSM, Maternity Benefit Scheme, RCH1, IMNC, Integrated Management of Childhood Illness, RCH2, Janani Suraksha Yojana, Navajat Shishu Surakshana Karinyam, Facilitated Integrated Management, Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyagram, Home-based newborn care, reproductive maternal newborn, child and adolescent health, Rashtriya Bal Swastika Karyagram, and India Newborn Action Plan. Like as a ascending order in various year, various program being launched by Government of India. It is giving special care, different component of the care in order to have better baby and prevent neonatal mortality rate. So UIP, I think it is a good old program, as immunization program launched. It is made as a mandatory for all the women supposed to undergo at least two TT vaccination to prevent newborn tetanus. And in the year of 1992, CSSM program started. We know very well the component of the CSSM program must be antenatal care to all pregnant women, safe delivery, and early establishment of the breathing at birth, newborn warmth, exclusive breastfeeding, prevention of infection, early detection and referral of high-risk cases and promotion of birth spacing. So it's been advocated by CSSM in the year of 1992, followed by National Maternity Benefit Scheme. It was launched as early in 1995. So some monetary benefit to be given for the below poverty line women and 8 to 12 weeks prior. So it's a hardly menial amount of 500 per birth, irrespective of the number of the children and the age of the woman. And so their focus, their mother should be eating the healthy food so that anemia, other nutritional deficiency can be prevented. And year of 1997, Reproductive Child Health Program launched by the Government of India. It integrated the component of the CSSM, what we discussed already, and Family Welfare Program given strength, and they just included even adolescent component and prevention of RTI and STI for the women. And in the year of 2004, Integrated Management of Childhood Illness Program launched. Again, it was just focusing of how to manage the childhood disorders that include inclusion of the baby. There are certain guidelines are there for how to care the baby till 1 week, and how to handle the malaria, anemic baby, when to give vitamin A supplementation, immunization. And also it is focusing of training of health professional when the baby is falling, sick to handle the baby. And in the year of 2005, RCH1 is converted to RCH2. And that is mainly focusing upon essential obstetric care, emergency obstetric care, and strengthening the referral system through NRH, integrating the NRH rural health mission. This component of the care is given. Of course, when you're improving the maternal Kshana Yojana, this is beyond the maternity benefit scheme, which is launched in the year of 1995. So here, it is focused on rather giving only monetary benefit, and it is just focused to reduce IMR, MMR through increased delivery. So it started propagating or motivating the mother to have institutional labor, rather at the lower level facility, home or lower care facility. Then something called Navajat Shishu Suraksha Karaniya. You don't just confuse all such terms. So it's all Hindi terms, as governmental program always launched in the capital of the country. And thing Shishu, Navajat mean newborn, Shishu mean children, Surakshana mean guarding, and Karyagram mean program. So the some program which is focusing towards the newborn, just born children. So here, as per this program, it was launched in the year of 2019, and mainly focusing giving more important for prevention of newborn hypothermia, infection, breastfeeding, and newborn resuscitation. So through the this program, NSSK program, mainly focusing of training of healthcare provider at various level of community health centers and primary health centers. Next program, facility integrated. So initially we learned something called integrated management of childhood illness, but here something some more component added, like facility integrated. What this facility integrated, of course, launched in the year of 2009. So this program offer extra management of aspectual management soon after the birth and care of sick newborn at the facility level. So these are the two other component added in the IMC and modified had been taken over by the Government of India. Then next program, Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram. So again, this program, JSSK program, launched in the year of 2011. This again motivate institutional. Janani Suraksha Yojana is giving cash award of minimal 500 and motivating for institutional labor. Further, this program is motivating the mothers to have a delivery in the institution. And also the something called cashless, it's removing the paying out of pocket or cashless benefit being received during the normal as well as cesarean. I think a few hospital do adopted or taken over the system. Any mother who registered in the primary health center, either under Janani Surakshana or under Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy maternity scheme, that's Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy maternity scheme, only available in Tamil Nadu, not in other state. So through that, they can, if they register themselves, they can receive free care in the institution who are recognized. Not all the institution, many institutions are recognized. We are, so as a mother, we have to identify so that they can receive the free intranatal care, delivery care, even for normal as well as cesarean. And even in case of sickness, the newborn care, baby entitled to receive sick newborn care without any money. This assures the mother to reach to the hospital for their delivery. And next component, the year of 2013, they introduced something called home-based newborn care. As for home-based newborn care, so they recognized majority of the newborn death do occur in the home, like 25 to 50% after they getting discharged. So nowadays, a mother getting discharged by 48 hours, and also few mother even within few hours they wanted to just go home. So as they are reaching home early, and death occur other than the medical reason, like hypothermia, like hypoglycemia, death is higher. So they developed this a component like home-based newborn care in the year of 2013. So as per this, ASHA or ANM are likely to visit the babies in the days given. So as 6 visits made by the ASHAs or ANM. And so they do just give all such care what being discussed. Then 2013, one more program is launched, Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram. So it is nothing but the making the baby more than survive. Thrive is very important. So this program is focusing on the screening of all the children with the birth defect, disease, deficiency, and the developmental delay, and early referral and appropriate management. That's it. And the eternal program, reproductive maternal newborn and adolescent. So starting from the birth till the reproductive phase, this program is just covering. This launched in the year of 2013. So the key component are, as during reproductive period, the spacing is to be given either postpartum IUCD insertion or interval or any time after delivery IUCD, and home-directed contraception, like contraception to be delivered even at home, and ensuring of spacing birth. And even pregnancy, to avoid unwanted or early diagnosis of pregnancy, test kit to be given even at the level, at home level, and the sterilization services can be given. and maternal health use of MCT tracking system, like mother child tracking system, is with the availability of technology is being taken care, and all the through that all the high risk pregnancy is tracked, and training of health personnel is given more important under this scheme, and review of maternal infant death and reason and measure to modify it. Identify the low institutional delivery areas, and incentive is given to ANM to promote institutional delivery. Newborn care exclusive breastfeeding, home-based newborn care through ASHA, essential newborn care, special newborn care unit to be developed, use of antibiotic given in the home level. And child health component like nutrition, diarrhea management, prevention of pneumonia, immunization coverage, and training, what is the program you have seen. So training of the health worker to handle such IMNC packages. Then adolescent is, they were generally left out category. And so the measures taken to prevent teenage pregnancy through pre-education, they are given, care education, they are given information. And strengthening of adolescent reproductive sexual health. So far, they are focusing only on the reproductive woman after the marriage. But through adolescent program, they started just focusing on the adolescent reproductive health. And even adolescent itself, the iron supplementation initiative was and menstrual hygiene is very important for the normal reproduction. So that being given insistence. So this is about RMNCH plus A intervention. And the latest, the last program, something called India Newborn Action Plan, which was launched by the Indian government by the year of 2014. So as per this program, it is targeted NMR to be less than 10 by 2030. And so how, through the surveillance mechanism and tracking of birth and stillbirth, and focusing and ending preventable death among newborn and mother through quality care. Prioritize the baby like high-risk baby, identifying and referred properly, and aspiring towards the equitable care, like the care, no difference between boys and girls, rural and urban kids, and rich and poor, the care to be propagated. Under the care, certain important principle they do just involve, like equity, gender, quality of care, convergence. And so convergence, they insist, rather survive, thrive is very important. And accountability for each care and partnership with academies and other institutions, they have to look for. So the other important six pillar they are focusing, that all we continuum care we discuss, like pre-consumption care, care during birth, immediate newborn care, essential newborn care, care at the sick. So, and care beyond newborn survival has been given important as per India Newborn Action Plan. And not only it is just launching the program, each program is set certain target. So this target is helping the healthcare professional to reach the desired level of newborn health and prevent NMR less than 10 by the year of 2030. So it's all indicator, I think list of indicator is available. It is available in the INAP module. So number of percentage of early neonatal death, newborn mortality, underby death, number of SNCU and NSU care unit, and number of women, birth of women between 15 to 19 years, percentage of women who receive ANC care, management of anemia, percentage of women getting treated for PEH, and the percentage of women deliver safe, care of percentage of preterm baby, and care of healthy baby, for care of small and sick newborn, care beyond survival. As I am going on telling, the government of India is not only looking for survival, it's looking for thrive. Thrive means they could be able to have normal growth and development without any much defect. So these are very many indicators being set by the government of India. Hopefully, all such national program which is launched will help to meet such such target. To conclude, by the discussion, we understood there is a remarkable progress being made in reduction of NMR, but still there is NMR rate is high, especially low and middle income country. and it is our personal responsibility to take all the measures so no preventable death occurred between newborn during stillbirth period or during infant period. So our focus must be rather child to survive, no making the child to just live and making them to thrive and reach their full potential. The baby who born in the earth should have a normal growth and development, free from any illness, sickness, so they will reach their full potential. This should be our aim and this should be our ultimate goal of giving a care to the mother as well as newborn. With that, I wanted to just finish a small quote by Philip Jackson. Is of course is a basketball player. He was talking, the strength of the team is in each individual member. The same time, the strength of each member is in the team. So the individual supplement to the team support to the individual. So it maybe it's not only fit go well for the team game, even the team effort to meet the national target by following this small word, I think we could be able to achieve the national target and make the baby live happily and not making the baby having full thrive. These are the certain guidelines I just used as a reference. With that, I wanted to thank everyone for the patient listening. Organizers, organizers,
hello.
Yes, madam, I have completed.
Thank you, ma'am, for your presentation.
Yes, ma'am. Any queries from the audience?
Wait, ma'am. Wait. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, madam. Renuka, you know who's online, our principal, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Now, this is the time to clarifying your queries. We can move for the questionnaire session. For some of the questions are visible in our chat box, I can introduce and invite Ms. Jayanti, nursing tutor, child health nursing, for questionnaire session.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, madam. Any query has come?
Yes, ma'am. The first question is,
yes,
nurse's responsibility in golden hours.
Golden hours has been discussed in initial slide. Let me again throw the slide.
Okay, ma'am.
Establishment of respiration, prevention of hypothermia, establishment of breastfeeding, prevention of infection, and identification of risk among the newborn. So by this, I think you can just handle the golden time. So principle of TABC to be followed.
Yes, ma'am.
By that, we can tackle the golden hour.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. The second question is, ma'am.
Yes, madam.
The baby born with 1.5 kg.
Yes.
The baby also preterm, ma'am.
Yes.
So the baby monitored by a CPAP.
Yes.
After regulation of the CPAP, but baby getting frequent apnea. Why the reason is, ma'am?
Maybe as a preterm, it may not develop the respiratory center, may not be mature enough to support.
Okay, ma'am.
So oxygen insufficiency. Maybe that indicate baby need to be given supplemental oxygen, either the mask or depend upon the oxygen saturation.
Okay, ma'am.
Baby may not be mature enough to withstand in the normal environment.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, the next question is, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So breastfeeding is important, no, ma'am? But yes, within half an hour.
Yes.
practical issues is there, no ma'am? LSCS, during the LSCS surgery?
Yes, not only LSCS, you don't talk about LSCS. Me, okay, as a OBG nurse, I know what is going on in the labor room. So all bothered about suturing the woman and attending the perineum. So just leave away the importance of early breastfeeding. So it is obviously the nurse's role to just convince the mother as well as the health professional who are attending, doing the sutures. And you have to convince and make the baby do. It is obviously a challenge, but a little interest and awareness about the concept. I think in the labor room, I could see usually PGs do the suture. Many times they not give much importance. So as we insist, I could be able to just tackle the challenge, just creating. But usually senior doctors may not. But the learner usually have their task. They wanted to finish off their care of the woman rather. So it's just taking initiativeness that makes the problem solved. We have to create awareness. Very simple, create awareness, motivate. That will help to solve the problem.
Okay, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am, next question, ma'am. So nowadays the COVID-19 is most prevalent disease, no, ma'am? So yes. If the mother is affected, COVID-19 means?
Yes.
How to prevent?
It's not, mother has to take all the measure to, like PPV says to you. Government is highly recommending breastfeeding should not be stopped, should be continued, and she should wear the maximum PPE so that she can give the thing. After PPE and cleaning the breast thoroughly, she can advocate it to just, we cannot just replace with the other feeds. So COVID is not a contraindication to stop the breastfeeding. Highly advocated by proper PPE by the mother and proper cleansing of the breast. Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. That's all, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Jain.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for your reflective knowledge with us, ma'am.
Yes, thank you, Sneha.
Thank you.
So again, at this juncture, I would like to thank the Nanda Educational Trust as well as the principal HOD of Pediatric Nursing, Professor Renuka. All other faculty members, and of course, the participants, students, initially I could see about 85 to 90 participants, they were line. I hope they must be from various college and your college too. Obviously, it is just recalled refreshment of knowledge. So at least they got a few extra information, I believe. And I thank everyone for the opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. So now we need to make some important announcement. The feedback. The feedback link is already sent to your email ID along with your Zoom link. So go through and submit to receive your e-certificate participation. Now we can invite our Professor V. Renuga for giving out of thanks.
A warm and delightful evening to Honorable Chairman, our most invited resource person, respected Secretary, Chief Administrative Officer, Principal, and all the participants. Wow, what an event. It is really great that this webinar turned out to be very successful. I am here to present a vote of thanks to all who have helped us making this webinar a resounding success. I raise my hearty gratitude and thank the Almighty God for his blessing throughout this session. First of all, I am extremely grateful to Sri Shanmugan, Chairman, Sri Nanda Educational Trust, Sri S. Nandakumar Pradeep, Secretary, Sri Nanda Educational Trust, Sri S. Thirumuthi, Secretary, Sri Nanda Educational Institution, for giving us an opportunity to organize this virtual platform. Thank you, sir. I extend my sincere thanks to our distinguished resource person, Dr. S. Rajeshwari, MSc Nursing PhD, RN, RM Reader, and HOD Department of OBG, Sri Ramachandra Institute of Higher Education and Research, Porur, Chennai, for making this excellent presentation and making this webinar interesting and meaningful. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to take this opportunity to express my hearty thanks to Trikay Krishnamurthy, Chief Administrative Officer, Nanda Educational Institution, for his unstained support and guidance. Thank you, sir. I also want to thank our principal, Professor R. Vasanthi, principal, and the College of Nursing for taking effort to make this webinar possible and conducting and promoting with other colleges for participants. Thank you, ma'am. I'm happy to express a vote of thanks to our beloved HODs and all class coordinator and staff members for encouraging students to participate and also guiding the participant too. Thank you all. Finally, the wonderful faculties and the students who have turned up in such great numbers, not only from our college, but also from other colleges. Thank you so much for your cooperation. Once again, thank you guys for making this event successful with contribution. May God continue to bless you all. All of us, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your gratitude wishes. The feedback form of this webinar will be active. Kindly submit it to your feedback and receive your e-certificate. There, your people are giving a correct email ID. Then only you can receive your e-certificate to your registered mail ID. And also, this today's session will be visible in our Nanda TV channel for today's live session. So those who are having any future references meet, you can go through in that too. Kindly like and subscribe our channel to support us. Go for further update. Thank you. Thank you once again. We hope to see you all again in next webinar coming soon. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Shall you wind away?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Okay.